large, ferocious soldier with many a self-aggrandizing story to tell. Trembling soldier, the soldier can't decide which is more dangerous, abandoning his post or standing this close to the bear. This soldier doing his job, but doesn't seem all that happy about it. And sergeant is in charge of keeping this camp and the bear in order. Tent looks roomier on the inside than one might think. Right, I have what you asked for. If I make your protective talisman, you'll let me into this tent. Like we agreed upon? Yes. I suppose I wouldn't have much to worry about. Right. Here you are. As requested, one protective talisman. Here, this ought to shield you from harm, for a time. He grins nervously as he puts the charm around his neck. Then he clobbers himself in the face with his own fist. Wow, you weren't kidding. So that's nowhere near the kind of punishment the bear can dish out. I better find some more stuff to test out with. Then I'll give that bear a piece of my mind. He stumbles off into the camp to find other objects to try against his newfound protection, leaving the bear's tent unattended. Simple fool. Get all of this treasure we have in here. Empty jar, some meaty morsels, and look, a torn teddy bear, how cute. A ragged toy bear, well loved and well beyond its prime. Yes, this should do nicely. Oh, wait a second. In this chest here. Wine, meaty morsels, grain. There might be other chests around here. I'll check after I make this potion. Okay. Honey. As you squeeze the honeycomb with your bare hands, thick, rich honey slowly oozes into the brewery's tank. Too sweet for your taste, but then this potion is not for you. You ladle out a good portion of the writhing, tar-like substance into the brewery. To be safe, you add a little bit more, just for texture. And this cute little teddy bear. You pause before dropping the tattered plaything into the brewery. A glint in its button eye reminds you of something, but the thought soon evaporates from your mind. You overturn your palm, and the stuffed bear splashes down into the concoction. It floats sadly for a moment, before becoming waterlogged and disappearing under the surface. With the addition of the final ingredient, the brewing equipment is sealed and set to work. Steam hisses from rivets. And its swollen belly clanks and rattles. Before long, the waggling fingers of the gauges and dials settle down, indicating that the brew is complete. You give a quick sniff test and recoil at the sickeningly sweet vapors. You push an empty wooden keg under the contraption's spigot and crank the release valve. The brewery strains under the pressure and fills the keg with chunky, oozing fluid. May not be the finest honey mead around, but hopefully that great raging galoot won't stop to notice the difference. The brewery wheezes in defeat. You doubt it will ever make mead again. All right. One keg of mystery mead for the big brute. Where was I? Oh, right. So I pull my sword out from the chest and... all that's left to do is give the bear his honey mead. There you go! Ah, Captain, I've brought you more honey mead. The bear swipes up the tankard with his massive paw and tosses the contents into his slavering maw without hesitation. He licks his chops, savoring the peculiar flavor with a sudden jerk. He bears down on you with suspicion. Hey, this tastes kind of funny. What did you do, soldier? It's a new recipe. I thought you might enjoy something with a little more sting in it. You know I hate new things. I'll teach you to mess with my favorite brew, you hayseed. The bear is upon you with frightening speed. He raises the huge mace and his paw skyward, and you brace for the impact. With an equal measure of speed, the sergeant leaps between the crashing mace and your head. You peer through your fingers as a great clang resounds through the camp. The bear roars furiously as his blow is magically repelled from the sergeant's talisman. The mace goes spinning out of his paw and falls into the lake with a great splash. He gapes dumbfounded as the sergeant stands before him, completely unharmed. Ah, that'll teach you to pick on us, you big oaf. This has been a long time coming. The sergeant wags his finger at the bear. Who do you think you are, huh? You think you're so big and tough with your fancy feather hat and your big honking club? Well, look at you now. The camp soldiers gather to witness the stunned awe. Miraculously, the bear seems to shrink in the face of the sergeant's onslaught. If it were up to me, you'd be dishonorably discharged for disorderly conduct. You're a disgrace to the uniform. You're no captain of mine. With a fear welling up in his eyes, the bear shrinks and shrinks until he's reduced to the size of a small cat. And another thing, what's happening? In place of the bear's drunken grimace is the stitched smile of a doll's grin. Two button eyes stare back at the disapproving faces around the little plush toy. The sergeant takes a step back to reveal the small shape of a stuffed teddy bear. Where the brute once stood. Your transformative potion has finally done its work. Gee, I guess I overdid it. He scratches his head in befuddlement, but seems genuinely relieved. Hey, Sarge, I guess that means you're in charge now, right? Oh, yeah, I guess it does. Well, What are you all standing around for? The camp's a mess. Let's get to work. I'll take that. You pick up the diminutive doll and brush some of sand out of its fur. As you inspect it further, its head lolls to face you. Far within the glassy surface of its button eyes, you can barely make out a tiny crimson flame. The trapped soul of the bear. This ought to teach you to be what the old goat... Oh, this ought to be what the old goat is after. I hope he's happy. The souls of the bear, leech, snake, and ox jostle in your satchel with fearful energy. That's that then. I better get these back to the goat before he ransacks the rest of the place. Before I do. I would like to collect some more embers. I'm fresh out of those. And there's plenty of ash piles around here. Get back here. Also, are there any other chests that I can just take a look through? That's all. I also see some reeds here. Definitely need more reedy twine. Fortunately, I'm not seeing any more chests. Well, I best not delay. Oh, hold on. Delay just a moment more. Here. Right now, let's not delay a moment more. Get back to that goat and find out why there's a maiden in the shrine behind my house. The goat rears its head at the sight of you. Its hooves pound the ground excitedly. More excellent. Oh, most excellent. I can sense the presence of spirits about you. You must have captured the souls I have asked for. Yes, no small task, I can tell you that. Just what do you plan on doing with them? Oh, this and that. Nothing you must concern yourself with. What's important is that you are one step closer to fulfilling your contract with me. Just go ahead and place them in the shrine there. I'll take care of the rest. The goat shakes its head towards a carved relief at the back of the room, grinning in a horrible way that no goat should. You approach the shrine and open your satchel. As you bring the stuffed bear close to the carved stone relief in the wall, it spontaneously bursts into flames in your hands, burning away until only a harsh red stone remains. The stone zips out of your grasp and straight into a socket on the wall, buzzing like some angry insect. You are buffeted by flashes of the bear's wrath, drunken, roaring, cowering bodies, splintered wood, the smell of honey. The shrine awaits another offering. As with the first, the mummified husk of the leech turns to ash as you bring it close to the wall, leaving only a glowing orb in its place. Images of the leech slither into your mind. The prick of a needle. The drip, drip, drip of draining fluids. Soothing words. Restless sleep. Shrine awaits another offering. Prismatic colors flash through your head at the thought of the snake, secrets lapped up by a forked tongue, whispers beneath the sound of festivity. The shrine awaits another offering. The ox brings with him the overbearing heat of the midday sun, the salty tang of sweat in the soil, suffering, sacrifice, salt. You step away from the shrine and its smoldering stone. Your burdens suddenly feel much lighter. Besides you, the sleeping maiden stirs in her slumber, but does not wake. Now then, you've had a very long day, why don't you get some rest? Tomorrow we shall pick up bright and early. Yes, I am quite tired.